Maybe we have all experienced that while we are sound asleep we woke up because we were urinating. Isn't that annoying? Because it's boring to get up at that time. But did you know this incident saved the men just because he was going to the CR to pee? This saved him from the sinking of their ship, and the miracle here, he was the only one who survived them all. How did it happen? How did he survive under the sea for 3 days? That's what we'll find out in Life Amazing Stories. Let's meet Harrison Okene, the only survivor of the sinking ship in the Atlantic Ocean. Before we start, subscribe to our channel so you are always updated with our new videos. Let's start. The Gulf of Guinea in the Atlantic Ocean is rich in oil, so many offshore oil rigs are doing drilling operations in this ocean. But on May 26, 2013, there was a company, and it was Chevron Corporation, that sent 3 ships. Those 3 ships were non-stop drilling even though the waves were strong that day. The mistake they made with the 3rd ship was that they filled the tankers with oil even though they knew the waves were strong in those days. On the night of that day, before they went to sleep, they locked their rooms. They also locked the main door of the ship, because pirates were rampant in this ocean. They were afraid that pirates might enter them at 4:30 in the morning, while they were all sound asleep. Harrison Okene woke up because he was peeing. Harrison Okene is a cook on this ship. When he was about to enter the CR, he felt like the wave was strange at those times, but he didn't pay attention, because he was still very drowsy, and he really needed to pee. When he peed just a minute later, suddenly a series of strong waves hit their ship, as if a giant were punching their ship. He rolled inside the CR, with his shorts still down. He remembered that their ship was fully loaded with oil, so if someone hit again with such a strong wave, their ship would surely capsize. When he was ready to stand, the strong waves hit it again and their ship slowly capsized. Here the water entered quickly, because the ship was already upside down and slowly sinking. 10 of his colleagues were in their respective rooms, and, because the rooms were locked, they did not immediately open the door due to the force and pressure of the water pushing on the doors. He pushed the door of the CR really hard to get out, but it was difficult. He struggled, because of the pressure of the water pushing against it. Here he saw his comrades in a panic, swimming out, but unfortunately due to the size of the water, and the strength of the force that entered the ship, his comrades were swept away. He was very scared when he saw his comrades drowned. As he watched, he did not realize that the big water was also coming. He did not stop at mentioning of my lord help us. He was pushed by the water onto the other CR, with a large air pocket on it. This air pocket is the spaces of the area that contains oxygen. He quickly touched the upside down wash basin so his head was lifted out of the water, while half of his body was submerged in water. A few minutes later he felt that their ship had hit the deepest part of the sea. The depth of the sea was 100 feet, so their ship was steady under the sea upside down. When their ship sank, the follow-up rescue operation of other ships immediately followed. Another helicopter also arrived to check in other parts of the sea. If any life had drifted there, the diving crews also dived to find the sunken ship. When they saw the ship, they dropped anchor for it to be a sign of the rescuers. The anchor hit the sunken ship and Harrison Okene heard and felt it. He replied by hitting the wall in case the rescue divers, but they did not hear it, because they did not reach the location of the ship. Because they are not ready for deep diving, so they are only a bit above the sea, and they can only be here for a few minutes. The divers are just looking afar to check if there are still signs of survivor. When they were sure that there was really no survivor, they went up as well. What they didn't know, there is a one survivor inside the ship. Harrison has also been inside the CR for almost a day, so he thought of swimming to see if there's a tunnel. So he mustered the courage to swim, and he was a little dizzy from what he saw, because the ship and equipment were upside down. While he was swimming, he saw the floating bodies of his other colleagues, so he was a little sad and scared, but he did not give up in the sadness, and he continued to swim until he landed in the engineer's office. Here he stopped first, and he was lucky, because the air pocket is bigger here. The air pocket is almost 4 feet here, so he doesn't have a problem with oxygen in case his body has been soaked in water for a long time, so he is also getting cold, and it's a bit dangerous, because it will cause hypothermia. In case his body has been soaked in water for a long time, so he is also getting cold, and it is quite dangerous, because it can cause hypothermia. What is hypothermia? It is a condition in which our body temperature drops so fast that we can die. While in the engineer's office, he saw tools that he could use here. And because he had been cold for a while, his body was soaked in water, so he thought he had to make a footing. So what he did was he peeled off the rest of the wall panel, and he also saw a floating bed. Then what he did was he stacked them to make sure that his foot would not sink into it. So he went up in the water, and he stepped on it. Here he sat for a long time to avoid hypothermia. He was very hungry and very thirsty, so what he did was he drank seawater to relieve his thirst and hunger. He also cried because he remembered his family. Then he prayed fervently and promised God that if he was saved here, he would never return to the sea to work on the ship. A few hours later, the skin of his tongue was slowly peeling because of drinking seawater. He also smelled the pungent odor around him. He suspected that it was the decaying bodies of his colleagues. His surroundings were so quiet that he could hear all the small sounds. He could also hear the fish feasting on the bodies of his colleagues. While the dive support vessel taken by their company arrived, this is a professional deep-sea salvage company. They were paid to retrieve the bodies of their crew members. They are professional deep-sea divers. They have enough experience, and the equipment is sophisticated so they can handle 100 feet deep-sea. Their team is made up of 6 professional deep-sea divers, deck crews, and technical staff. They know that their retrieval operation will not be easy because the ship capsized, so the ground and mud were disturbed. So it caused the water to blur at the bottom, so they knew it would be a bit difficult for them to see the bottom. What they did, they divided into 2 teams, the 6 divers each. They were 3 in a team. The dive team 1 was on the other side of the ship. The dive team 2 consisted of Nico Van Heerden, Andre Erasmus, and Arilus Thuzen, and a supervisor at the top of the ship, who in turn monitored through a camera and microphone. He will be the eye in case he sees something strange. The camera is in Nico's head. The dive team 2 took a long time to open the 2 iron doors. When they opened them, they were a bit surprised because of the amount of soil that opened up on them. It was a bit difficult for them to see because the inside of the ship was already dark, and the equipment was floating like chairs and tables. They avoided the floating furniture, and they slowly explored the ship. They recovered 4 corpses, while Nico entered through a door to the main deck. This entrance is small, so he also had a hard time while he was swimming, when someone suddenly grabbed him. Nico was a little scared, because he thought there was just a big fish passing by him, so he ignored it, and went straight to swimming because in the minds of the divers all the passengers on the ship were dead. So it didn't even cross Nico's mind that the one holding him was a living person, so what Harrison did was he hit the wall repeatedly, but the divers couldn't hear him. Then while he was hitting the wall, he saw again the second diver swimming too fast. The diver swam, he couldn't reach it to touch, so he seemed to be losing hope. Meanwhile, Nico's supervisor above checked the videos, and he saw the hand holding Nico, so he shouted into the microphone, "There is still alive, there is still alive, come back." So they went back to the way they went through. And here they saw Harrison. They were shocked because Harrison was alive, because in this depth of the sea no man can live without diver's equipment, even if the diver's the lowest depth of them is 130 feet, and they couldn't last 100 feet for more than 20 minutes. Meanwhile, when they saw Harrison, they were just right, because the air pocket where Harrison was staying was about to run out of oxygen. Because Harrison was under the sea for 60 hours, if the divers did not come immediately, he could have carbon dioxide build up in his body. This condition is called hypercapnia. Its effect is dizziness, headache, loss of consciousness, and the most severe is the seizure. Exactly, because Harrison started to experience dizziness, so the divers immediately gave him oxygen, and then poured hot water on him to raise his temperature. Meanwhile, medical experts are ready at the top, but there is another problem that Harrison will face, and this is decompression sickness. What is decompression sickness? When divers go to the very bottom of the sea, the pressure changes, and the nitrogen goes to the tissues. When they rise, the pressure it will change again, so the nitrogen will come out of the tissue and go into the blood, which is fatal, which can cause neurological problem or cardiac arrest. Because nitrogen is not needed by the body, he was first given oxygen for 20 minutes, and then he put on a diving helmet, and he jumped on the diving bell, and they slowly lifted it. When he was on the ship, he thought he was only under the sea for 12 hours. What he didn't know was that he was under the sea for 60 hours, or more than 2 days after what was done to him. He was put in the decompression chamber for 2 days. To prevent decompression sickness, other divers under the sea are still continuing the retrieval operation. They got the 10 corpses of his colleagues here, and they ended the retrieval operation. Harrison's condition also improved, and he ate vigorously. He also went home to their house, but every night he was dreaming and shouting. He thought he was still under the sea. He had post-traumatic stress disorder, and then he did not go to the grave of his co-workers because in Nigeria, there were superstitions that he might have used black magic, so he was the only one who survived the ship. So he didn't go, because he didn't want to blame the families they left behind. He remembered when he was still under the sea, he promised God that he would never work on the ship again. Do you think if you are in Harrison's situation, you can also survive for 3 days under the sea? Just comment below for your answer.